All right, I am putting together a video for this turbo for a 1.6 liter 16 valve Suzuki Geo Tracker motor. Now I got this through Kimmy Van Gillespie. It's off of the Geo Chevy Tracker and Suzuki Samurai Sidekick Owners Club. So there was a lot of talk about it. I decided, hey, you know, I was told everything, you know, read that everything I need is going to be in this kit to be able to install this turbo. So I thought, great. I asked a couple questions. Everybody assured me, yeah, this is the way to go. You know, get some extra power. So I ordered it. Took 6 weeks to get. Little kind of on the long side for shipping. And I got boxes, and here they are. I just opened these just to take a little peek, but essentially this is exactly what came to mind. So this first one here, I'll open this one up. It has components in it. Let's just start taking them out and put them out for us here. See what we all have. Got some plastic boots. Here's a down pipe for the exhaust. Throw that over here. Fuel regulator. Oh, the turbo. Breather. Vacuum. Connecting all this stuff. Some more stuff. Here's some vacuum line. It's like very badly crushed. I mean, I can't use this. That's not going to be any good. Some fuel line. Some more lines here. Bag of holes clamps. There's some gasket, a gasket in there, a couple of them. Right. Braided line. Let's see if I can get this out of here. Blow off valve. A little short pipe. The air cleaner. Exhaust manifold. Couple more pipes. Another two. Some more of these. Looks like a fuel pump. Couple loose bolts in the bottom of here. Oh, look at this. Hope I didn't lose anything out of that hole. Like to know, but this is what I got. Don't have any parts list, so I can't check it off to make sure that I got everything. And there's no instructions, which, you know, essentially, it's all pretty self-explanatory, maybe. Now, I know that there's pictures on this Facebook site of some different ones installed. So that's all I got to go off of, I guess. Sure would like to have something. Now, it doesn't need to be, you know, this boot connects on to this one, that's all basic stuff. But what I would be interested in is, you know, what are the adjustments to this pop-off valve? What are suggested? Fuel pressure regulator. Yeah, you know, you got your in and out on this, but there is some fuel gain adjustments on here. You know, not familiar with the fuel regulator, so I'm not really sure what I need to adjust on that. This is going to have some kind of adjustment. I know that it goes right here, but you know, at what length you put that on, apparently I'll just wing it. And fuel and vacuum lines. Yeah, what's the best place to connect those two? I don't know, because I don't have anything telling me what to do. Let's open this up. Okay. Those glass. I'll set these out here. Got all kinds of them, which is good. So obviously there's a lot of hoses here, so I'm gonna need hose clamps. Some caps for who knows what. Another T vacuum line, a little short one. Put your gasket. Alright, here's a barb bedding for something, another gas line. And a bunch of bolts and stuff. Alright, so that's what you get in the kit. Somebody stated on there that the kit comes with everything that you need to install this. I did ask a question about the air cleaner, and I was told that that didn't come with it, but it does. And I did ask about the exhaust, so I got the downpipe. Obviously, I'll have to do the rest. So I didn't even expect this part here. So I did get that. That's cool. But again, didn't even know that there was a fuel pump in here. I don't know what I'm supposed to do with that. I apparently change out mine. Yeah, a lot of parts here. Wish I knew where they all went. That would be really nice to know. So, yeah, we'll see where this goes. I'm gonna lay this out how I think it's supposed to go. I mean, obviously the tubing's gonna be easy. I'll be able to assemble all this stuff, get it on the exhaust. A lot of it I can see, but a lot of it I can't. So I gotta figure out where all this stuff goes. Gonna be a real treat. So I'll get back with you in a little bit after I get going here, because assembling this stuff isn't gonna be too thrilling. Alright, so I got these parts pretty much loosely put together just so I could see where everything goes. But as you can notice here, there are quite a few things that I'm really not sure where they go. Scoot over here. So, got this main assembly put together, exhaust manifold, turbo, get some of it started here, put together. But I've got a lot, you know, these, I know that I've got to hook up these vacuum lines to certain places, don't know exactly where. Would be really nice to know recommended areas for doing so. Otherwise, you know, I don't know where these are supposed to go. These are caps for something, vacuum line caps. Where do they go? You know, some smaller vacuum lines. Yeah. T's. Okay. I know this is supposed to go in the, turbo. Where's the other end go? I don't know. Yeah. So I'm kind of at a standstill. Till I get some instructions on this thing, because there's just too many components here to not have any kind of install. I looked at as many photos as I could on the internet of and started asking people if they had already worked on starting to install theirs, and maybe some people that have put these turbos in before, different vehicles, different stuff. Yeah.
probably could get by figuring out where all this stuff goes, but damn. I've rebuilt motors, small blocks, from the ground up, but that's a small block Chevy engine. This is a foreign job here, and my first turbo could use a little help. I'll let you know how things progress. See how many days it takes for me to decide how long it's going to take to get this thing put in. See you soon. All right, I said I was going to put together a video on how to install this thing, so here we go. Starting from scratch so we can see how this all goes. First time doing one of these, so I might not get it all right away. And I'll probably do some time lapse just because some of it's going to be boring. Forgive my hands getting in the way because I'm sure that's going to happen. And my nephew said that's a real pain. So I'll try not to do that. But yeah, let's get started. I'm also going to replace the valve cover gasket because perfect time to do it right now. Okay, I got a couple of covers here that need to go on, and one goes right here. Alright, and the other one goes right across here. The vacuum, so I'm not going to really need anything there. What should I do next? Those are just the basics right there, so I'm gonna start here next. Get this exhaust manifold off, which at this point nobody needs to be showed how to do that. Same with the down to the cat. I think I'm gonna do that off camera because you can watch how to do that on another YouTube if you need it. So I'm going to take this off and then I'll be back on. Take off the O2 sensor plug right up here just so I don't have to try to wrench it up down on the exhaust. There we go. So I'm just unplugging that from there. I'll drop it out. Easier to work with. Alright, should be able to sneak this out. Oh. Here we go. Okay, the next thing I gotta do is tap into the block for the oil line. That is right underneath the exhaust manifold, which I've taken off here. And right below that is this rubber boot on top of the oil sensor. Right next to that, right there next to it, is another plug. And now it's gonna be kinda tight. I'm gonna see if I can get in there, otherwise I'm gonna have to put a T on here. But I'm gonna do that off camera because it's kind of hard to hold this and do this, and you know what I'm doing anyway. Okay, so what's going in there is this plug, and that'll, the braided line will go into that one. All right, be back in a flash. Okay, so this is what I'm going to wind up doing here. Going into the block where the oil pressure sensor was. Putting a block, a T-block in there with this, and then coming off with the oil supply. So essentially it's going to be like this, coming out of the block. Now I'm sure you can find, you know, a T that's going to have a threaded end on it, but I wasn't going to have the guys at the auto shop search anymore for it because I want to get this done. So this is the configuration I'm going with. All right, so that's the finished example of how I'm doing mine. I'll see if I got enough clearance. It's got 1.5 inches to the oil filter. It's good that direction. Should be good all the way around. So we'll find out. I'll check for oil leaks later. Make sure that everything's copacetic. All right, back to, let's see. In the next phase, I think I'm going to do the oil return to the oil pan. So that is down below. So I'll have to reset up and see if I can show you what I'm going to do there. Now, after I get this done, I'm going to do an oil change because I noticed I got to drill into the oil pan. You can do it one or two ways. Drill into the oil pan. I'll put a backer nut on it, maybe. And put the oil pan back up. Or you can drill a hole. And you know, hopefully you drill the hole the right size so it's pretty tight just to seal it up. It's non-pressure, so it's just going to be a good seal to keep the oil from splashing out. But I'm just going to do the hole inside of the oil pan. I'll show you that next. Okay, sorry about the music. I got to drill a hole right here for this oil return. Now, you can take off your oil pan, but then, you know, you got a whole mess of stuff to deal with there. Or you can drill it out. And guess what? I got an angle drill. All right. So I got the hole drilled. Yeah, definitely flush this. So once I get this in here, I'm going to back drain the oil and back flush it. Or pour it right down into this tube and just push it, any of the chips out. Otherwise, I hope the screen on the pump and the filter do their job. But looky what I got. I got a tap. So basically that's a 1/2-inch pipe tap. Will allow for threading this in here. Now it's only going to give me about 1/2 a thread. But 1/2 a thread is better than no thread. So that's my next step. Those threads cut in there so nicely, I don't know that I even will need to seal this. So I'm just gonna wait and see what happens. If I get some oil spillage out of there, I'll come back and reseal it. But right now, it's awesome. Show you that next. Okay, sorry about the music in the background. It drives me nuts, but you gotta keep employees happy. Well, anyway, I am torquing the exhaust manifold to specs at this point. Make sure you do that. Otherwise, you know, you're just not a gentleman. Okay, I'm doing a little pre-assembly on the turbo here. So this piece here for your oil goes in this fitting right here. Boy, that's a tight fit. I suppose it's a pipe thread. I probably don't need any Teflon on it. Thank you. Yeah, I put Teflon on it. Let's put on the downpipe now that we're doing all the big bolts. Plus, I gotta, once I get the tubing on here, that's gonna be covered. So, I'm gonna put on the downpipe now. Actually, my old O2 sensor, you know how they make those? They put a glass usually on the threads so that it melts and binds itself in there. I torqued on mine a little bit, couldn't get it off, so I just ordered a new one to replace here. That might be, let's just see where it's going to end up. If it's in the way or if it's going to be a pain in the butt, I'm just going to wait. Well, yeah, it's pretty tight. I'm thinking I'm going to wait. I'm gonna wait on that until I get that in. The downpipe for the coming off the blower, and I just went to a local supply shop and got a couple elbows. I'm gonna put this in. Not much to show on that. So I'm going to be able to come up from the bottom side, bolt it right on, and next.
Shouldn't be too bad.
Okay, I made a little bracket for my fuel pressure regulator right here that I'm going to mount onto the firewall. It'll sit there just like, yay. Okay, the next thing I'm gonna do, start hooking up these gas lines. Now this is supposed to be in from the rail out to the tank. So that is exactly what I'm gonna do. The actual supply is down here. Let me take this and show you. So as you look down here, you've got two stacked right on top of each other. It's this one right here. So that will go from the rail to the end, out to the tank. All right, I'm gonna hook up my vacuum lines now, but one thing that I forgot to do, and I'll do that right now, is this goes to the bottom of the throttle body here, so I am going to hook that into this port right here. I'm just going to reuse this clamp. So, scoot him on down yonder. Let's see here. Don't want to kink this. This goes somewhere right here. This up, yay! My video got cut off, so I am just going to show you how I put together the vacuum lines here. Came with a couple T's. There was three T's in this little kit. I take it the third one is for putting a vacuum gauge in here someplace. But I came off this port. You got one that goes to the FMU. The other one goes to the T, which goes to the fuel rail regulator. And this top one here goes yonder to blow off valve. This tube here on top of this fitting comes across, hooks up right here. Last but not least, the one that comes off here on the blower comes over to this banjo right over here on this side. Just loops around. Now, one thing I want to show you quick here is my air cleaner is sitting pretty high, kind of stuffed in here, but my hood does still close. Okay, I gotta run this vacuum line from here to right here, but I gotta orientate this first, so I'm not gonna put this on quite yet. Okay, I'm gonna move the orientation of this drain tube down. I'm going to loosen up these, which are fairly loose. Small hands, so this makes it easier for me. Well, I actually start to hook up some of the hoses here. Get this pretty much buttoned up. Put a vacuum line from here to here. So you might have to orientate that a little bit. Then you get this guy. It's got to come in here like this. So make sure. Here we are with everything pretty much tightened up. Got all the holes clamped in where they're supposed to be. Let's tighten down. Got the all the sensors drilled in here. You can see that one drilled into the bottom. Make sure these are all tightened down correctly. Exhaust is on. Vacuum hoses are set up. Got the one coming off of this T to the blow off valve. This one goes to the FMU. Gas lines in from the rail out to the tank. I'm going to be setting that up next. Well, first I'm going to do an oil change. So the tube that return tube I have not connected yet. I'm going to use that to dump oil down into, clear out those chips. Otherwise, getting pretty close to firing this bad boy up.